Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So for today's video, as you guys can see by the title, today we're going to be talking about my experience getting Moo cremated. It was the first time I've ever had a pet cremated, so I wanted to talk to you guys a little bit about my experience. Some of you guys asked me to film this video on my experience and show you guys what I ended up getting from the cremation place and stuff like that, so I thought that I would film it for you guys today. I've never gotten an animal cremated before, so this was definitely an unusual experience, but it went really, really well, and I really want to talk a little bit about the company that I used as well. They are based here in Nashville, and they're amazing. I shouldn't cry in this video. I don't think that I will. If I do, it's fine. I don't care. Obviously, I'm not afraid to cry, and it's not a bad thing or anything, but I've had some time to process the loss of Moo. It's been 2 weeks since she passed, and it's been a week since I picked up her ashes from the crematory place, So I want to talk a little bit about the place that I got Moo cremated at. It is based here in Nashville. It's called Faithful Friends Pet Memorial Services LLC, and it is based in Nashville. This is just the gift bag that they sent her home in, and also they did something else for me, which is absolutely so sweet. I can't wait to show you guys that because it's adorable. This video is not sponsored or anything by this company. They don't even know I have a channel. They don't even know that I'm mentioning them in a video. I just wanted to shout them out and give them a really positive review because they were the sweetest people. Like, literally, I walked in, I was crying, and the daughter was like hugging me. Like, they're that sweet. So I wanted to mention them in this video. So this is the bag that the pet cremation place sent me home with. You can see they have their sticker on the front and it says Moo. So basically, I called them. I set up a date to go and take Moo in. I took her in, and then basically they went over and discussed everything with me that they would be doing, and then they went over everything that they offer and everything like that. The reason that I chose this pet cremation place is because they do offer private cremation, so that whenever they cremate your pet, it's by itself and it's not a group cremation where they basically like cremate multiple animals at the same time. It's done privately, so you only get back your pet's ashes back, and that was really important to me that I only get Moo back in my custody. I didn't want other people's pets or anything like that in the ashes. That might sound kind of morbid, but I'm just trying to explain how it all works. So if you're ever needing to get a pet cremated, you kind of know what's out there and like what your options are. But they only do private cremation. That was another thing that I loved when I called them. That meant a lot to me. Also, they also did all of the cremating on site, so they didn't send Moo anywhere. I was crying when I got there just thinking about leaving her. That was already hard enough for me. So once I got there, the lady was like, "This is your chain of custody paper," and I have all of that here. So basically, they filled out this paper. I can't show you because it has like my phone number and address and stuff on it, but it's basically like a carbon copy of a chain of custody paper. And basically, she fills it out, she signs it, she has you sign it and everything. And it's called the chain of custody. So basically, because all the cremations are done there on site, they never send your pet off. And I think her exact wording was like, once you give us your pet does not leave this building until you come back to pick them up. And that's how she said it. And I was like, that just gave me a lot of comfort to know that Moo wasn't getting sent anywhere. You know, she was going to be in that building from the time that I dropped her off to the time that I picked her up. And that just, I don't know, when you're a ball of emotions, little things like that really mean a lot. Like, I can't really explain it, but I was really upset that day dropping her off, so it meant a lot to me. So I want to talk a little bit about the sweet little touches that they did that meant a lot to me. The first little touch that they did was the bag, like I showed you. The next little touch they did was they actually had a little personalized certificate of cremation, and it has the date of your pet's cremation and like a really sweet little saying and stuff, and I thought that was really nice. So that was the second thing that they gave me. The next thing that they gave me, which I thought was a nice touch, they didn't have to, was actually this velvet bag, and it says, "Until we meet again at the Rainbow Bridge," and it's just embroidered with that saying. And if a pet parent doesn't have an urn, they'll basically just put the ashes in a bag and then they'll put them inside of this velvet drawstring bag, which I obviously already had Moo's urn because I had been mentally preparing for this for months before it happened, just so that I wouldn't be hit by it so hard, you know, and not know what to do or how to deal with it. And then of course we have Moo here in her urn, which sounds so sad to say, but basically this is it. I already showed you guys this urn in the video where I told you she passed away, but basically she is in here. I'll always have her, and for some reason that brings me comfort, even if it's like this much comfort. It still brings me comfort to know that I have her and I'll always have her. And she's in here, and I did choose to not seal the top so that if I ever wanted to make jewelry or anything out of her ashes, I am free to do that. I do have that choice. So this is not sealed. I can take the lid off and her ashes are in a Ziploc bag inside of here. So it was really well done. It's very easy to get her in and out and things like that. So that was really important to me as well. So that is Moo's ashes. So depressing. And then the last thing that I want to talk about is something that I really cannot even believe that they did, and it's so sweet. This is probably the sweetest thing that they did for me, and I honestly can't believe it. It's something that they offered. I knew that they offered it, but I didn't think that I was going to get one, you know? So she had this for me whenever I went to pick up Moo. This is basically a clay paw print of Moo. See if you guys can see it. I know it's a little hard to focus. So this is what it looks like. It is a framed clay paw print impression of Moo with a heart around it. So when I was there, I saw one of these sitting up and I was like, oh, I didn't know you offered that, you know? And she was like, yeah, we do that for pets and stuff. You can get their paw print impression or whatever before we cremate them. And I didn't know if it would work out because, you know, Moo was so little and her little feet were so small. Oh, I love her. But the lady said that she wanted to try it. And I was like, okay, I didn't think it would turn out and I didn't know. And, you know, the heart around it, she said that she actually went and bought a cookie cutter and then took the cookie cutter and imprinted the heart around Moo's feet. And that just, it's just so sweet and it's so beautiful. So this is what it looks like. It's a really pretty wood, and the wood actually matches all of my furniture in the living room too. So I thought that was really sweet. And then on the back here, it just has their company and then it has Moo and all of that information on there, which I thought was really sweet. Not sponsored, but if you're in Nashville and you're looking for a place to take your pet after they pass, this company was just amazing. Like, I don't have enough good things to say about them. They were so sweet. And honestly, like, this means so much to me to have. Like, it's just so sweet to me. But yeah, all in all, it was a great experience. They were very, very sweet, very loving people. I highly recommend them if you're in Nashville. Again, not sponsored. They don't even know that I'm shouting them out, but they were very sweet, very affordable, very generous, very, very sweet people. So I highly recommend them. Also, I know you guys still see Moo's tank. I have just been grieving the past few weeks, and I just come in here and I see it every day. And for some reason, it kind of makes me feel like she's still here, and that has really been helping me cope. I know that's so weird. Like, I didn't know how I was gonna feel after, you know, she passed away, or how I would deal with it, you know, other than just being heartbroken. But having her tank here and having her ashes and stuff, it's just like little tiny things that help me along, I guess, in the grieving process, if that makes any sense. And having her tank there, it just makes me feel better right now, and I'm not ready to take it down. So it could be in the background of a couple more videos at least. I don't know. I just know that I'm not ready to take it down yet. So when it disappears, you guys will know. You'll see that, obviously. I did want to film this video for you guys because I know you guys loved Moo, and I wanted this to kind of just be like a closing to her story. At the end of this video, I am going to include a lot of clips that I've saved up over the couple years of Moo. I just kind of want to do like a tribute video to her. For anyone who wants to watch that, you are welcome to. Moo is the sweetest hamster that I've ever seen. Definitely the sweetest dwarf I've ever seen on camera or otherwise. I loved her dearly. I loved her with all my heart. I'll miss her forever. And yeah, I just love her and I miss her. And I know you guys loved her too. I'm gonna be okay. Everything's fine. I've had a couple weeks to process it, so I'm doing better now. I'm doing better. Believe it or not, I'm doing better. But yeah, thank you guys for watching this video. I really appreciate it. I will see you guys next time. Be kind. Bye. Good morning. Good morning, my baby. I love you.
Hi, baby. You ready for your medicine?
Come on.
Hi, baby.
Come here. No, no, come on. Bad. No, ma'am.
You're bad.
Now then, go, Mr. Cobb.
Did she tell you?
You've known all along.
What are you doing?
Just getting some fresh air. Stay where you are, Mom.
Oh. Good girl.
She likes it, huh?
Good girl. Good girl. Good girl. Such a good girl.
Oh, here, princess. I got your worms, princess. Yeah. You sleepy? Such a good girl. Good morning. What are you doing awake today?
I love you. You're such a good girl. Happy birthday. Mama loves you. Happy birthday, Momo. Say bye-bye. Bye-bye.